आर यू एबल टू सी द स्लाइड? एनीवन रिस्पॉन्ड?
यस सर,
यस सर।
ओके फाइन, देन आई एम गोइंग फॉरवर्ड। टुडे अगेन वी विल टॉक अबाउट फर्दर रिजल्ट ऑन कॉन्वर्सिटी ऑफ फंक्शन बेस्ड ऑन मॉडर्न टेक्निक दैट वी आर कॉलिंग इट कैलकुलस ऑफ कॉन्वेक्स फंक्शन। इट इज नॉट ओनली अबाउट डिफरेंशिएशन इंटीग्रेशन, वी हैव टू डील विद सेवरल अदर काइंड ऑफ कंपोजिशन काइंड ऑफ अप्रोच। सो डिटेल ऑफ द कोर्स इज ऑलरेडी मेंशन हियर। आई एम कमिंग टू आउटलाइन ऑफ माय टुडेज लेक्चर्स। फर्स्ट आई वुड गुड अगेन गिव ए रिकैप ऑफ फोनिक कॉम्बिनेशन दैट प्रिजर्व city of a function that if you are saying piecewise nothing, just it is talking about point wise maximization of collection of linear function. So piecewise linear is very important in many other perspective, like when you will study dynamical system or control system, or especially in robotics, what you have to do, you have to stabilize your system. In order to stabilize your system, you have to find an energy like function. That function we are calling it V. That Lipnov function is very important in that perspective. So if you are able to find Lipnov function for a system, it is empty hard. Finding Lipnov function is an empty hard problem for stability of a dynamical system, whether it is coming from perspective of whichever field. Then it is an empty hard problem. So how can you find? So we can find it by converting this Lipnov function as a convex of three important class of convex optimization problem that we are calling it semi-definite programming problem. So we will discuss that time this kind of thing. So if you see any kind of Lipnov function, it happens to be point-wise maximization of function, point-wise maximization of convex function. So that's way. Very simplest energy function is this function, x square kind of function. This one is energy function. It looks very simple and smooth, but it is not always possible that this function x square will serve as a Lipnov function for any kind of dynamical system. So generalized perspective, you have to go for the better representation of this one. But remember that your Lipnov function, it would be always convex in nature, and it would be a solution of this a special kind of convex optimization problem. Those things we will discuss later. And then I had discussed about point wise supremum also preserve convexity. So one example was support function. So if you are having a set, then for that set you can define a variety of support with respect to given different directions. So if you are taking a direction x, then with respect to this direction you can define a support of set S. Like what would be this one? It is a supremum, pointwise supremum function, supremum of a very linear kind of function x transpose y, so that y is coming from the set, underlined set S. So it is a supremum function. So this function would be always supreme support function, always happens to be a convex function, and it is defined with respect to supremum. That's it. Those things in last class we had already discussed about. Then I will discuss in detail in this class regarding composition. Suppose you are having two functions f and g, and if you compose this function, and you know that f and g both are convex, and if you compose these, that means f of g. Then what about this composed function? Can we say that this composed function is a convex or not? So it is not always true. Under certain condition, composition of two convex function is a convex function. So that criteria we will discuss in detail. So criteria is that the first function must be in increasing function. Then you can observe the preservativity of convex function. Then I will give a minimization problem, or another name of this one we are calling it partial minimization. Under partial minimization, function again happens to be a convex function. If function is having a block variable, then you can define a partial minimization with respect to that. This function is a convex function. It preserves convexity. Again, perspective function also it preserves convexity. Perspective function is nothing, just it is talking about projection from Rn dimension, Rn plus one dimension, that means graph of the function to n dimensional space. It is a projection kind of function to Rn. So those things we will discuss in this class. Coming to recap of only combinations, I will take an example only. I want to go again through. So I in last class I had already mentioned that what is happening if you are having a function like this one, this very complicated function. So how can you establish the convexity of these two functions? So this function you can say that it is to the power 4 of affine function. So you are having a affine function y equal to affine or linear function, both are similar. Whether you call it linear or affine, it is not going to change. So you are having a affine function x1 minus twice of x2, and always we know that this function is a affine function, happens to be a convex function. Then after that you compose with 4 to the power 4, then composition of affine function, and we know that y to the power 4 is always again a convex function. So composition of a convex function with affine function is always a convex function. That's why first term is convex. Now if you are coming in second term, it is talking about composition of exponential function y with affine function y, and we know that e to the power y, if you simply see, it is a convex function. So here we are talking about composition of this exponential function with affine function y. Y is what here? Y is, it defines a plane in 3D. Y is equal to 3D. So it is a affine function. So from these two rules, easily we can establish this function is a convex function. We don't have to go for all those first order or second order characterization. Without that, we can establish this one. So I will talk about one more example like this one. If you are defining here, you are having a function like this. What do you do? So what is happening here? This function is very complicated kind of function. You can observe that if you are going to define with respect to Hessian, it would be very difficult to find Hessian. This function is talking about a square of norm of ax plus b, where a is any m by n matrix. That means this one is the affine transformation. In law also we observe one linear function. So how can we define convexity of this one? So don't, and for the further condition, what is the domain of this one? We assume that this quantity is greater than or equal to 0. That means we are just taking upper half a space. This one is upper half a space of upper space defined by this hyperplane C transpose x plus b equal to 0. So upper, so just for the positiveness. And now what we do in order to define convexity of this function, we will introduce one equivalent or surrogate function that we are calling it here. Again, always consider this affine function, give a single name, argument name y. This affine argument give a name y. So it, with that perspective, it will take form norm square of y divided by t, and this affine function also we are giving a single name t. Okay, so now h we are defining, it is a surrogate function of f of x. Now if you try to open this square norm, we know that from this definition of a square norm, it can be written as in this form. Each component would be yi square by t. So this kind of component, say it simply, you can say that h is a summation of this n number of summation of this kind of function. And now in second order, it is very easy to establish convexity of this function. So in second order characterization, we had already seen the convexity of this function y square by x, and we had already calculated Hessian of this one. Hessian was positive definite function. Hessian of this function, it was positive definite function. So from there easily, it is very easy to look convexity of this single function where y is a single variable and x is another variable. So it happens to be a positive definite Hessian. Due to that, this component is a convex function, each component. And similarly, if you add each yi square by t, then you will get h. So it will imply that your h is also convex. This function h is convex. And what is the relation between h and f? It is talking h and f, that h is, if you do a fine transformation, you will get fx. So just replace, that means you replace y by a time x equal to a time x plus b, and t equal to the c transpose x plus b, then you will get your fx. So you, using the condition of convexity of this function of two variable y square by x and summation criteria, that means conic combination, you can easily establish that your h is a convex function. Due to that, this function fx, corresponding function fx, would be a convex function. You don't have to calculate Hessian here, just you need to calculate Hessian of y square by h. It is a very simple, it would be a 2x2 matrix, easy to calculate. Now further, I will recall few things from point wise maximum and point wise supremum. So in last class we had already seen that if you are having a collection of hyperplane and you are finding point wise maximum, then point wise maximum always happens to be a convex set. From the graph it is very much clear, you can see that. Similarly, if you are having a collection of hyperplane in three dimensional space, further find point wise maximum, then again that collection would happen to be like this way, and it give a convex pattern. This one is in R2. Now coming to important part of today's lecture, that we are calling it, first we will compose a function with a scalar function. That means we are taking a function, convex function, function of several variable f, or simply call it g. We are taking a function g from Rn to R, and then we are taking a scalar function. That means a function, what is meaning of a scalar? Domain and codomain both are just set of real number. So we are taking a scalar function h from R to R. So this kind of scenario is coming. So here what is happening? Here g is also convex and h is also convex. But in general, we can't talk about convexity of composition function h of g. Yeah, so we will talk about convexity composition of h with g. That means if you put here argument x, h of g, it is defined as h of px. And you know all about composition property of function of two variables. From there you can derive those properties. Those are just plus two level concept. So here mostly I would like to discuss about preservation of convexity under composition. So in general it is not true. Suppose here I have taken example, generally convexity is not preserved under composition. Here it would be not preserved under in a special cases convexity is preserved. Like we have taken two function, g of x is x square, so x square is a convex function. It is, this is the plot of x square. From the plot easily you can say that it is a convex function. And similarly, if you are taking h, another function, x square minus 4, that means that one is also convex function. X square minus 4, it will cut x axis at 2 and minus 2. So both function happens, this one is your g, versus x. This one is h versus f. So from the plot, easily you can plot, and from the plot you can express that both are convex. But what about composition of these two functions? So composition of these two functions is x square minus 4 to the power 2, whole to the power 2. So what you observe here, so this function is no more convex. I have taken plot here. So in plot, if you are taking value x between minus a square root of 4 by 3 and 4 by 3, then you observe little bit concavity. So here you can observe that this function is not convex. Here it is coming like this way. So there is a curvature, negative curvature. You observe here, there is a small negative curvature. It doesn't look very clear in this graph, but if you zoom it, then easily you can observe that small negative. So simply, I would like to say that this function, this composition function, is having a small negative curvature. So due to that negative curvature, this function is no more convex due to this one. And why? Despite of being this function x square minus 4 whole square 2, it is a composition of two convex function, but composition is not a convex function. So due to that composition, the doesn't preserve convexity in general. I'm taking one more example here. I have taken it a plot. I have done all this plot there in R. Also, you can apply R, is also very fancy. So here, what I have taken, two function. One function is x square, another function is minus log x. You know that x square is again a convex function. A square is a convex function. Also, minus log x is a convex function. You can draw, this is a, from the curvature plot, easily you can identify these two functions, h and g, are convex. But if you compose these two functions, the composition is no more convex. So again, it will observe that it is not very smooth. So it is coming. So here there is a small negative curvature. So here in this segment, a small negative curvature. Due to that negative curvature, you can say that this function minus log x whole square is not a convex. It is not a convex function. So due to it is enough to mention that composition in general doesn't preserve convexity. But what is the special case of composition where it preserves convexity of two functions? So that special case here I will talk about. Here, what composition we are taking? So suppose g is our function g, function of several variable g, it is convex. H is also convex. Then composition of H with G, it will be convex, provided there are two conditions. Provided your function G, that inside function G, call it inside function G, it must be convex. Then outside function or enclosing function G, H, it also must be convex. Apart from that, the extension of H, or simply H also you can call it, H is non-decreasing. Non-decreasing, that means if H is increasing, non-decreasing, it is equivalent to increasing in layman sense. If your inside function G is convex, outside function or enclosing function H is convex, and apart from being convex, your H also must be non-decreasing, then you can claim that the composition function is a convex function. So this property is very important. You need to understand this property. Apart from convexity of enclosing function or outside function, you need to put condition over that that function must be non-decreasing. Now there is one more scenario. If suppose your inside function g is concave and outside function or enclosing function h is convex and also non-increasing, that means decreasing. Remember that if your inside function is concave, then condition over h is must be convex and non-increasing, that means decreasing function, then also in that situation your composition function would be a would preserve convexity, it would be a convex function. So these two important property are very important and giving a lot of interesting result. If you want to see proof, through proof you can observe that. So if you want to find the second derivative, from we know that from second order characterization the Hessian must be greater than or equal to zero. If you are taking n equal to 1, then if Hessian, it becomes this function of it becomes a number. So if you calculate Hessian, this quantity h, here it is talking about second derivative of h, and because we know that h is convex, due to that second derivative will be always positive, and g, this term is dealing with a square, so a square of anything is always non-negative, greater than or equal to zero, so there is no issue. So in first term, in the derivative of f, you won't face any problem. Problem will occur in the second term. So again here, second derivative of g, it is talking about second derivative of g, and you know that you have taken condition g is convex. Due to convexity, your second derivative would be always non-negative, that means this quantity would be always greater than or equal to zero. So where is the problem? Problem is, it is coming in the first derivative of h, that enclosing function or outside function. So when first derivative of function is non-negative, when the function is increasing, monotonically increasing, or in another way non-decreasing, so that's where this criteria is coming. So it is underlined in the definition of second derivative of composition function. From there easily you can look into, if you put this condition over outside function or enclosing function, easily you can say that your function would be a convex function, your composition will preserve convexity. I will take the example. This one was the proof for n equal to 1. So I will take the example here. Simply I have written in one line, g must be convex, enclosing function or outside function h is non-decreasing and convex. Then you can claim that composition function of h with g is always a convex function. So one example, easily you can see it like this one. So here it is composition of two functions. Here composition of exponential function, your enclosing function is exponential function, and your inside function is g function. So we know that the enclosing function e to the power x, it is exponential function, and we know that the exponential function is always non-decreasing and convex. That means if you want to plot the graph of exponential function, how does it come? It will come like this way. This is the plot of exponential function. Is coming like this. So you can observe that it is having first condition, it is having a non-negative curvature, that means convexity is opening up, so that's due to that it is a convex first, and second it is non-decreasing, that means it is increasing. So first you can observe it is a convex. Why? Because curvature is non-negative, and second is it is non-decreasing. Why? Because also from the derivative you can say that derivative is always non-negative, so that's why this function is an increasing function, or here it is increasing function. So from the graph easily you can talk about increasing property and convexity of the enclosing function or outside function. Now if you come to second function is what? It is just a square of norm. So if you, so two norm I have taken, so if you taking function of one variable, two norm would be what? X square function. It is just a quadratic function kind of structure it will give. So always it is a convex function. So you are having two convex function. Apart from that, you observe that your outside function is your non-decreasing and convex. Due to that, this function is always a convex function. This is a convex function. You don't have to do any kind of algebra or calculation. Without doing calculation directly, you can say that looking into that these functions g and h, identify g and h, and from there establish a convexity of g and h. Also establish that non-decreasingness or increasiness of h. From there you can establish that this function, the resultant function, is a composition function, is a convex function. Similarly, if you take one other example, f of x, here it is talking about a square of a square norm plus 1. So here your g is a square norm plus 1. So it is what? It is again, if you are taking just one dimensional number, so what is the norm of that? It is simply a square kind of function. So it has been divided by 1 along y x2 axis. So graph of this one, it would come like at x equal to 0, it is taking value 1. So just like this structure is coming. So your g is very nice function, it is convex. From the plot easily you can observe. Now come to see h. H is x square function. The h is, x square is not a monotonically increasing. Then can we claim that this function is a increasing function? Now this function is a convex function? Simply we can't say. What? But look into the definition of composition function. With composition function, this is what it is defined as h of g. So what is the primary condition of defining a composition function? That primary condition is that it is defined as h of g. That means it says that domain range of the enclosing inside function, range of inside function, g is the inside function, range of inside function must contain, or simply take range of inside function, range is of g. If you define h and observe that your h is increasing or non-decreasing, in h is non-decreasing, you can observe that h is non-decreasing in the range of g, is non-decreasing. That means I am giving sign arrow, this upward arrow. This sign also, it is talking about non-decreasing or increasing function. So you can, what is the range of this function? Range of this function is just collection of set of our real number, which is greater than the positive real number. So set of collection of all positive real number, we denote it by r plus plus. If you take single sign, that is means that includes zero as well, that non-negative number. If you take another plus, it is talking about collection of all real number which are strictly greater than zero. That is positive real number. R plus plus is talking about positive real number. So what is the range of g? Range of g is R plus plus. And in R plus plus, look the behavior of x square. What is the behavior of x square in R plus plus? So in R plus plus plus, x square is always increasing. Due to that, you can claim that this function is a convex function. So it is directly coming from the nature of or definition of composition function. So always see behavior of enclosing function or outside function in the range of inside function g. If h happens to be non-decreasing or increasing in the range of inside function g, then you can claim that the composed function is a convex function. Simple criteria. I have taken one. So here I had already written range of this function f g. Range of this function g was set of positive real number where h is always non-decreasing, and hence f is convex. So now I will talk one more important result, that we'll take a function of several variable g, that means from Rn to R, and we will take again function of another variable. We will not take a scalar function of a scalar variable, we will take function of vector variable. So that's where vector function is written here. So we are taking function Rn to R, then we are defining one more function Rn to R. Suppose g is a vector function Rn to Rk. and h is a function which is defined from what would be domain of h, because h happens to be your enclosing function or outside function. So domain of h must be range of, it will come from codomain of g. That means so simply that's why rk I have written. So h is defined from rk to r. So what about composition? So we will define a composition h of g, and we will talk about the condition under which composition preserve convexity. So what is that condition? That condition is also similar for the case of a scalar function, what we had already discussed. So it is similar kind of things. So we will talk about composition. So condition is coming here like this way. So g is a function from Rn to Rk and it is convex. H is also a function from Rk to R, such that we are defining a new function f of x equal to h of gx. H of gx, then it would be convex only if and only if your inside function g is convex, your outside or enclosing function h is convex. Apart from convexity, it is also non-decreasing with respect to each argument. Remember that here g of x is now vector valued function. So the vector valued function is having component. It will have how many component? It is defined up to in codomain is rk, so it will have k number of component. So first component of g is g1, we calling. So g1 is what? So you know from calculus all what are all those. Second component is g2x, g2 of x, and each gi you can call it, it is each gi, that means gi is component of in the given function vector valued function g. Each gi is a function, real valued function, that means function from Rn to R. And it will go, this component will go up to k, kth component. So gk of x. So with respect to each component, your function, enclosing function or outside function h is non-decreasing or increasing function, then you can claim that this composed function is a convex function. Similarly, if your inside function g is concave and h, enclosing function or outside function h happens to be convex, and with respect to that, due to this concavity, you have to take this h non-increasing, that means decreasing function with respect to each argument. With respect to each argument, then you can claim that your composed function would be a convex function. So example, very famous example I will talk about. Proof is again very similar. It is similar to whatever in a scalar case we had proved that. So find the derivative of n equal to 1. Take n equal to 1. Find the derivative, second derivative of f. So it is a composed function. So it will be what? Derivative of g times Hessian of h times again derivative of g. So there is no issue with this first term. Why? Because we know that we have taken already h is a convex function. Due to that, Hessian of that convex function always happens to be positive semi-definite. That means non-negative. So due to that, if you are taking any quadratic form, or that means x transpose x of any positive definite matrix is always positive definite matrix, we generally denote by p. So x transpose x, where p is a positive definite matrix, then this quadratic form is always greater than or equal to zero, a scalar. So this quantity would be a scalar quantity, x transpose px. You know that what is the dimension of x? It is, suppose you are in two dimensional. So dimension of x would be 1 by 2. So dimension of x transpose would be 1, 2. Dimension of x would be 2 by 1, as we consider as a column vector. So dimension of x, x transpose would be 1 by 2 as a matrix. And what is P? P would be 2 by 2 matrix. And x is what? We are taking as a column vector. So it is a matrix, 2 by 1 matrix. So if you do just matrix multiplication in computable form, so what would be 1 by 2, 2 by 1, 2 by 2, 2 by 1. So resultant would be 1 by 1. What does it mean? Simply it says that x transpose px, it is a scalar number. So if this quantity is greater than or equal to 0 for any positive semi-definite matrix. So due to that, that you can talk about first derivative is always positive. But problem will come here. So this, to make this quantity positive, you have to put condition here. This quantity would be second, it is talking about second derivative, and g is already convex. So due to that, this quantity would be again greater than or equal to 0. So when this gradient of h will be greater than or equal to 0, when gradient this h is non-decreasing in each argument, then it would be a greater than or equal to 0. So that's where this condition is coming from here. That's where. Similarly, you can see for case B as well. I am not discussing for case B. This scenario is only for case A. When G is convex, H is convex, and S is non-decreasing. So this is the proof for n equal to 1. I won't go to proof for all this. I will take few example here. So example on vector composition which preserve the convexity. What you do? You define a very famous kind of function, log sum exponential function. What does it is talking about? You are taking log of sum of exponential function. So logarithmic function in general, if you take logarithmic function of a convex function, then that would be not a convex function. Like what is log? We know that if when we define simply, we are taking x is what? Y equal to x, if you write, it is a affine function passing through origin. And if and log is what kind of function? Log is it is a concave function. It is coming like this way. So x is an affine function, that means it is a convex function. If you take log x, then what kind of function you are getting? This kind of function. This function is not a convex function, it is a concave function. So in generally, if you are taking a convex function and you apply, suppose g is your convex function, and you apply log over g, then you can't say that the function would be a convex or concave. In general, you can't. So it is very difficult to say that the convexity of g implies convexity of log of g. See, it is very difficult to say that. Not possible. Not, it is an ideal situation. But if you define a function like this way, argument wise, so here, if you keep on changing argument, if you just take g1, then it would be, and take g1 and g2 together, then what would happen? So with respect to argument, this logarithmic function is increasing. Due to that, g is already, we have taken convex function. So due to increment of logarithmic function with respect to its argument, it implies argument function, it implies that this function is a convex function. And I think time is already 45 minutes. So in next class, we will discuss about, we will establish convexity of a very important kind of class of function. This function, again, it is here in g of x, we are taking a linear function or a fine function. And then I will talk about convexity of this very important class of function. It is very a special case of, all these are a special case of this first example. And this function you might have already observed in neural network or in deep learning course. This function we are calling softmax function. If you take logarithm of both sides, then it will be turned into xi minus this log sum exponential function. So what does it say? That if you take log of fx, log of softmax function always happens to be a convex function, because it is a linear function. Linear function is always a convex function. Here negative, Okay, so and this function is also a convex function. Due to that, you can say that log f x. You can establish the convexity of softmax function. Okay, thank you. Thank you. If you are having any doubt, you can ask. Otherwise, I am going to wind up to this class. Regarding attendance, I had already created a link for attendance. Go and mark your presence there. In next class, I will discuss about minimization and perspective that preserve convexity. Anyone is having any doubt, you can ask. Otherwise, I am going to wind up today's class. Okay, one question is coming with respect to random function. So for random function, I haven't discussed right now. I will discuss it later. Right now, everything is about deterministic approach. So random, I will discuss in next class. Okay. Okay, fine. So actually, I don't want to complicate things. Many things if we discuss at the same place, then it would be confusing environment. So just sequentially I will try to discuss things.